Good morning, dear students. Today, we are going to discuss about the topic Neonatal Intensive Care Unit. It is also known as NICU. Neonatal Intensive Care Unit or NICU. It is a specialized area where critically ill neonates are cared to reduce the neonatal mortality and morbidity. If the child is neonatal in the critical condition, the neonate needs the care of intensive unit, mostly from the labor wards, operation theater, hospital, or any other referred, they will be sent to the intensive care unit. We can see what are the criteria for admission of NICU. First, low birth weight babies, that will be less than 2000 gram or 2 kg weight. Birth asphyxia, that is Apgar score less than or equal to 6. Meconium aspiration syndrome, that is the baby is aspirated meconium or liquor is stained with meconium and baby is delivered, then baby will aspirate the meconium, that is meconium aspirator syndrome. Severe jaundice, infant of a diabetic mother. Neonatal convulsions, severe congenital malformation, cyanotic congenital heart disease. Autotherapy, parenteral nutrition. Immediately after surgery, cardiological investigation. Exchange blood transfusion. Premature rupture of membrane or the liquor, that is foul smelling liquor. Mother of hepatitis B carrier. Injured neonates. These are the criteria for the admission in NICU. So all these conditions and some purposes also will admit the neonates in the intensive care unit. Next, we can see the aims and goals of NICU. First, to improve the critically ill neonates, keeping in mind the survival of neonates so as to reduce the neonatal mortality and morbidity. That is, critically ill neonates, we are admitting the NICU to reduce the neonatal mortality and morbidity rate. To provide continuing in-service training to medicine and nursing personnel in the care of newborn. So who are giving care in the newborn, that is medical people and the nursing people, they need the continuous or in-service training. So that will be provided in the NICU. Then to maintain the functions of the pulmonary, cardiovascular, renal and nervous system. So it will be maintained in the NICU. Then to monitor the heart rate of the heart rate, body temperature, blood pressure, central venous pressure, blood gases, the oxygen concentration of the blood is by oxygen analysis, all done in the NICU. Then to check or observe the alarm system signal to find out the changes beyond certain fixed limit set on the monitor. So we are observing the system, the normally in the monitors we will set the alarms and the normal range. So if it beyond the average or below the average, the alarms will be set alarmed. So that will be checked for observe the alarm system as signal to find out the changes beyond the certain fixed limits set on the monitors. These are the aims. Next, to administer precise amount of fluids and minute quantities of drugs through IV infusion pump. So neonates need only small amount of medicines. So that will be provided in the infusion pump or the infusion pumps. So that will be provided in the, so we have to monitor the neonates. So this will be provided in the NICU. These are the aims or goals of NICU. Next is preparation of NICU. What all things should be kept in mind? So warmth will be 33 to 36 degrees centigrade, that is in the incubator if there is incubator. Then adequate light source must be the resuscitation and treatment trolley with the adequate stock will be the and history continuation sheet, treatment and diet sheet, problem list and flow chart must be the oxygen air and suction apparatus, that is adequate oxygen supply and suction apparatus as available in the unit. Then oxygen line connected to oxygen and airflow meter. Suction, that is complete suction unit tubing and varying sizes of suction catheter. You all may be seen in the normal ICU. So that is a suction apparatus and a suction line and a oxygen line will be in the walls. This will be already connected in the walls. And ventilation bag and mask of appropriate sizes must be there. Vital signs monitors must be there. And specific equipment as indicated by the diagnosis of each condition must be there. These are the preparation in analysis. So you can see this is the single bed, that is there is a monitor, the warmer, infusion pumps, suction, this is suction, then oxygen connection tube. So everything we already said some of the things, so that all will be there. Then this is the it's big NICU with a lot of baby circuit. The distance you can see, each one have the separate warmer with every oxygen equipment. So this is set in the walls. Okay, this is a setup of NICU. Then we can see admission procedure in NICU. Following data should be collected within 24 hours of admission. History and examination that include maternal history, paternal history, that is the father's history, previous obstetrical history, details of present pregnancy, labor and delivery. That's all the present pregnancy, what all the drugs taken, any complication they had, the labor also, labor and delivery time, any complication they had, any difficulties they faced. So all the history should be taken within 24 hours of admission. Then finally APGAR score of the baby at the time of birth. Next, on admission, notify the doctor. What all things should be done by the nurse? So notify the doctor and the nurse in charge that a new baby is arrived and resuscitate the infant as necessary and maintain warmth. If the baby needs resuscitation, we have to do first the resuscitating the baby infant and maintain the warmth of the baby. Then check infant identification label and see whose baby is this, how much was the weight, what was up there. Everything should be written in the identification tag. So identification label should be checked. Then quickly examine the infant from head to toe. Set quick examination should be done from head to toe for obvious abnormalities, anything that condition permits. If the condition permits, only we have to do the quick examination. Then record the weight, length and head circumference as soon as possible. Then transfer to warm environment as soon as possible. And common observation are taken as temperature. The infant's normal temperature is 36 to 37 degrees centigrade. Then heart rate, respiration, color and activity should be observed. Then after all these procedures, you have to explain. The parents will be very anxiety when their newborn is in the NICU. So we have to explain to the parents about the condition of the baby and handover from transferring unit staff should be taken. Okay, these are the on admission thing. Then what all the records should be kept? Birth history, that is done in the labor ward history. Then ward history contains APGAR score and examination of the newborn sheet, infant sheet, neonatal weight and feed sheet progress chart. Compiled history contains patient registration form, progress sheet, intrauterine growth chart, O2 flow sheet, fluid balance sheet. These are the history contained, charts also contained. And how to make rounds with the consultant in the NICU. So we have to think, we have to maintain a lot of things while doing the rounds. So each baby, these details should be necessary. Examine and evaluate assigned patient each day. Every day you should be examined and evaluation should be done. So record keeping, that first is progress note, problem list. So what are the previous days, how much progress patient baby is in next day. Then what are the problems are facing the baby on this day. Then general status, is it better or worse from yesterday, or in no change of yesterday, and pertinent physical, any changes, the nutrition, about weight, change appropriate, inappropriate, caloric status and source and plan of nutrition. Next, respiratory problem, that is what is the present status of respiratory, that is how much is the respiration, or pertinent physical, any findings and laboratory findings of findings. And identification, infection include if specific suspected or present. We are suspecting there is a chance of or risk for infection or present any infection. Then cultural status, so cultural result should be there. And plan of therapy, how long antibiotic treatment should be planned according to the infection. Then apnea, number and severity of apnea, bradycardia treatment, any given like ventilation, patient is getting ventilation or not, caffeine of theophylline levels. Next, cardiovascular, physical findings, blood pressure, result of tests such as echo, treatment plans should be included. Then, fluid and electrolytes, that intake, output, electrolytes, problems and plan of the fluid and electrolytes according to the result. Next, metabolic changes, that is glucose, calcium, phosphate balance or any other problems should be checked. Then assessment and plan about the these metabolic changes. Next, the neurological problems, changes, medicines and plan, neurological problems, anything noted and any changes from yesterday, and what are the medication patient is getting and what are the plans. Next, seizure, patient, if the patient is has neurological problem, how much seizures patient baby had and what are the medication and blood levels and ECG result. And hematological, anemia, coagulopathy, neuropenia, etc. should be noted. And transfusions and plans, like if the HB is low, what are the transfusions we given and what are planning. Okay, then hepatic changes, renal problems, eyes when examined and results, and discharge, like if the patient is on discharge, so discharge summaries, transfer summaries may be done prior to the discharge of the patient. So while we doing the rounds, we have to, there is a baby, the baby is discharged, we have to take a summary, or that if the baby is transferring for the other hospital or other unit, we have to do the transfer summaries also must be done. That's all about the intensive care unit. So we till now discuss about the what is intensive neonatal intensive care unit and what are the patients usually, what are the conditions of neonates we usually admit in the NICU, and what are the goals, and what are the nurses responsibility, and what are the records maintaining, and what all the things should be kept in your hand while doing the rounds. I think all of you are clearly understood. Thank you.